what if I told you? Upon this rock I shall build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. But yet man trespass against man, making profit out of another man's labor. So what if I told you your pastor lied? He lied when he told you your money can substitute your presence in church. But sorry to burst your bubbles, grace does not cover you when your spirit is flexing. So sorry to tell you. So what if I told you your pastor lied? He lied when he told you you could keep sinning, spoon-fed by lies as you keep dining, clothed in sin while you keep singing. Praises to a God you are undermining with the messages you need for are not heart ranting, but make up tools for a soul that is ever dying. They say all of their doctrines are by Blinka, yet we don't see them working in Christ. All they do is wage a war against sinners from coming into the church. So they reserve the back benches for sinners and the front benches for saints. Meanwhile, the church is a hospital for sinners, not a club for saints. So what if I told you your pastor lied? He lied when he told you you must sow a seed to receive from God, but that God will be better than that. He lied when he told you you must sow your holy Isaac to receive from God. Don't get me wrong, I believe in seed sowing. Church, do you know? Do you know speaking in tongues is not the currency used for exchange in the marketplace? Do you know God is ready to provide, but there's no food for lazy man? So tell me, church, what is your definition for prosperity? Did the Holy Spirit told you your predecessor is your friend, your relative, or your son? Tell me, church, how many job opportunities have you created? Tell me, when was the last time you empowered your youth? I guess you would say it's the government responsibility. But which government are we following, theirs or Christ? Tell me, church, do you know the devil is a liar, but in the presence of God he speaks truth? Do you know the devil is a liar, but in the presence of God he speaks truth? So tell me, church, do you know why you chase after money? It's because your only prayer point is money plus drugs, just not life plus. So tell me, that saving money is important than saving. So yes, is saving money important than saving? So church, tell me, you build schools we can't afford, hospitals we can't run to, bookstores we can't pick up. Tell me, do your members know? Do they know Christianity is working on broken bottles to gain salvation? Tell me, do they know Christ did not just die to give people a career but to save the lost? Tell me, did they know Christ did not just die to give people a career but to save the lost? Tell me, do you preach yourself or you preach Christ's church? When was the last time you joyfully and proudly attend to the needs of your members? I mean, when was the last time you attend to the needs of the widows in your church? I get it now once in a year review. Tell me, when was the last time you visited the prison, the hospital? When was the last time you fed that kid on the street? Tell me, when was the last time you went to the orphanage to have dinner with those kids? Tell me, why do you collect tithes? Tell me, why do you collect tithes and offer, yet the needs of your members are not met? Church, tell me, do you know, do you feel faint or you feel fierce? If only your eyes could see souls and not bodies, how different will your definition for Christianity be? Church, tell me, if only your eyes could see souls, church, do you know heaven is not a finish line but a race we are running on? And you know this race is not about going to heaven but bringing heaven on. And do you know some of you, church, will continue even when the Holy Spirit leaves the church? Church, do you know religion is the demon we talked about? And the last time you met, you gave me an invitation to church. And when I came, you led me to prosperity, not to eternity. Church, tell me, why do you value first timers than first converts?